Okay, Kim, yet again, I want to welcome another sister-in-law, since I have six brothers. Welcome to our family, Kimberly Maddox Macias, or Macias Maddox, or however you guys are going to do it. What I really want to say is about time. You guys took your time, but here you are, happier than ever. Kim, like my boys call you, my chocolate cake. Man, you're awesome with all the kids. How you grab all the 20 kids now? 20 kids and take them to the park walking. Sissy, you've been not even my sis, my mom. Oh gosh. First of all, you and I think we butted heads so many times. Too many times. Even though I don't want to say I used to steal your Barbie dolls when we were little. And chop their heads off and throw them under the bed. And I never told you, but. But I love you, Sissy. I love you so much. You've been a big influence in my life with my kids. Letting me share, you know, the experience of having a girl, because I don't have any. But you're awesome. In my book, and Kim, oh my gosh, I can't even explain. I can't even begin to explain what a difference you've made in everybody's life, and the girls, I appreciate that, you know? I love you guys, congratulations, and hope you guys live happily ever after. Like Sister said, to infinity and beyond.
Fabulous, fabulous, fabulous family moment. And I sat over there and I thought, well, don't interrupt the family moment. Don't get on the mic. Don't die. Leave that alone, because that's family stuff. And... okay. But I think it was 1998, 97. Maybe 90. Is that right? Dag. Anyways, I'm Kenny. And we show up to work one day, and I could tell something's a little different. I'm kind of going, okay. And Kim goes, hey, Kenny, we got to do this, and then we got to go over here to more hospital.
Use your big boy,
and I said, y'all, Norma over here acting a fool. All right. Thank you, Norma. So, she's, I don't have my glasses on. So Kim shows up to work, and she says, we got to go over here to Memorial Hospital. And I'm like, okay, that seemed like it was important to you, so, okay, we're going to go to Memorial Hospital. We're going to do this, we're going to do that, and then we're going to go to Memorial Hospital. So we go to Memorial Hospital, but we don't actually go to the hospital. We go to this place off to the side. It's like an apartment building that the hospital has. It's an office building. And we walk up there, and there's a lady in there. She comes out, and he goes, hey, this is Angel, and this is Kenny, and how you doing? And they start, and I'm like, okay, oh, we're obviously not at work right now. We're doing something else. So anyways, I met Angel, and I thought, okay, Kim's acting a little different. What's going on here? So the reason I'm saying this is because right away, when they met each other, I saw the obvious difference in regards to how they acted around one another. So this is a beautiful conclusion to what I saw. And I wish you guys could have all been there the day that I saw when they first, it wasn't right when they first met, but it was shortly thereafter. Yeah. So there you go.
Oh, Go kids. Go kids. Go kids.
Go kids.
That's right.
That's a song right there. That's what I'm talking about. Come on, Angel. Work it.
Come here.
Felicidades, Timotea y la Sapo. A few people that are here, everybody's special, but these girls I went to high school with. We played on the basketball team and we call ourselves the real ballers. So this is Tori. Here you go. Don't say the year. Don't say the year.
I'm not going to say the year, but I never thought this would happen. Kim was always just an independent spirit and I didn't see her ever settling down, and I am so happy, and she is so blessed to have an angel in her life. And I am so glad to see them as a couple, and I'm so glad to be a part of this today. Thank you.
I'm Linda.
What? Don't say the year.
What year?
Don't say the year.
Two hours upside down.
It was 19.
Kim was our star athlete, and I have not, to this day, have seen anyone as good as she was.
Yes.
No one. I'm so happy for her and Angel. They're very nice.
Angel.
That's only congratulations, y'all. Oh, this is the best couple. And I wish you many years of happiness. Thank you.
My name is Arnetta, and I am the second youngest of this group. I'm not quite their age, but I have to say, Kim, it's been a while, and I'm glad to be here. Kim introduced me to my first malt liquor. I was a freshman in the year of blankety blank. I had the locker furthest from everybody else, so I had the malt liquor in my locker. And I was chosen, the one with the locker with the malt liquor. Thank you, Kim. Angel, it is a pleasure. It is a blessing to have you as our family. May you have many, many happy memories. You have a very large family. Very large family. And may that family grow to love you as two people who will love, who will teach, and who will love unconditionally this large family that you have.
Thank you.
Thank you, ballers. Back to the music.
just a break dancer. That's true.
I really want to thank the Macias family for accepting me into your life and treating me like a family member. My mom, could you please come here?
Please stand up.
My mom flew in from Florida to be here. I'm going to say this and I don't know if it's appropriate. She doesn't approve, but she loves me unconditionally. So my mom wanna speak and she's gonna prove me wrong, watch.
Go ahead, you're gonna say something.
Good afternoon. We are so glad you're here to witness this ceremony. And I'm glad to be here too. And I wanna wish Kim and Angel the best life ever.
Thank you, Mom.